you're Africans, you're Hispanics. But the scripture says it was going to be said ye are the living sun. So that's a prophecy right there. We're telling our people that you're not black, you're not Latino, you're not African. We're telling you that you're the Israelites the Bible speaks of, man. You're the sons of the Heavenly Father, man. The sons of the power. Okay? When the so-called white man, he calls you black, colored, Negro, nigga, spit, Hamite. I'm sorry, African. He don't call you the Hamite. He call you an African. Right? We're telling you otherwise. You're the sons of Yahweh. Bashem Yahweh Shah. Right? Verse 10 again. Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea, meaning you can't count us. They have these census come by your neighborhoods every so often to try to take a count of you. But you can't count us, man. We're innumerable as the sand of the sea. Okay? Meaning on. And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living God. So we're telling you that straight to your face, here in America, here in Babylon, the place of great confusion, that the children of Israel are you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, Mexicans, man, and anybody that go back to our people on their father's lineage, such as the Irish and the Italians, man. You got a lot of Italians, a lot of Irish people that go back to us, man. You got a lot of people that look like the rest of these nations that go back to us, man. Okay? Here in America, you said that. But people who work in those other captivities, man. In those other captivities. But here in America, we're letting you know that you're the sons of God, man. There's three classifications of men on the earth. The sons of God, the sons of the man, and the sons of the wicked, man. Who are the sons of the power? We told you, so-called Negro, Latinos, Native Americans. Who are the sons of men? All these other nations. Who are the sons of the wicked? The so-called white man, Edomites. Okay? Because our people under the sky, oh, I'm African American. What does that mean? Africa is a continent. The Americas is a continent. So what does that mean to call yourself an African American? You calling yourself two continents, man. There's no nation of the Africans. There's no nations of the Americans. Okay? All those are just made up terms, man. And we bring it to you out of the Bible, man. The same book that the majority of these people in this side here hate to read, man. And love to say, oh, it's a so-called white man's book. No, it's not, man. The Bible condemns the so-called white man. The Bible condemns all these heathen nations and two-thirds of Israel, man. The Bible speaks of salvation. What are we here for? To tell you that salvation has come unto the people on this sign here, man. And the people that go back to the people on this sign here. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. And salvation has come unto you, to the elect. Because they're not telling you that. Nobody's bringing that down. They're telling you that salvation is for everybody, anybody. That there's a place called hell where you burn forever for your sins, man. That's not scriptural, man. When you read the scriptures, you understand that hell is not a place to be burned. That is a condition. Heaven is a condition. When you read the scriptures, it tells you that there's no end of the people, man. Okay? It's Isaiah. So it's Ecclesiastes. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 15. Matter of fact, sorry, 16. Ecclesiastes 4, 16. There is no end of all people, even of all that have been before them. They also that come after shall rejoice in him. Surely this is also vanity in the vexation of spirit. So there's no end of the people. There's no end of the people that came before them, man. The same spirits that were here before the flood are the same spirits that's here today. That same evil and adulterous and wicked generation that was here during the time of Yahushua is here today. The Edomites were ancient people. They're here today, known as so-called white people, man. The Israelites were ancient people, and they're here today, known as so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American, Seminole Indian, Mexican, okay? We're here today. Scattered among all nations that are upon the face of the earth. Okay? So there's no end of the people. So when people like Bo Cam Malone says, oh, the Edomites have been done away with, well, show me in history, man. Because I'm going to show you in history where they weren't done away with, where they just went to different nations and they hid, calling themselves by different names. Okay? And laid open the book of the law, which is the book of the law, the Bible, okay? Which in the ancient times they were written in scrolls, okay? And laid open the book of the law where the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images. So who was the heathen that sought to paint the likeness of their images in the scriptures? The so-called white men, the Edomites, okay? When they took over our people, they took the law. They took everything from us, man. And they tried to replace all throughout the Middle Ages, people like King James, those are all black people. Queen Elizabeth, black people. Henry VIII, black. Charles I and V, black. Black boy. Why do you think they called Charles the V's son black boy, man? Okay? Said he was swart, man. Word swart goes back to swart, which means black. Okay? But they laid open the book of the law. But the heathen so paint the likeness of their images, man. And they did that. It's called iconoclasm. Okay? Iconoclasm, man. But you see, the majority of you people, you don't want a history lesson. You don't want to hear the truth. You don't want to hear this word. One, because it doesn't rebel with you. Okay? Two, not for you. Two-thirds of Israel, likewise, man. This word isn't even for you. You got two-thirds up in these churches on a so-called Sunday, sun worship day. Talking about God, God, Lord, Lord. Got the biggest Bibles in their hand. But guess what, man? They're going to be destroyed on this side, man. This truth, they're going to have to get in the kingdom, man. These very words, man. Okay? Okay, so the heathen, they laid open the book of the law where they saw in them paint their likenesses, man. And they eventually did that. They did that during the 14th century, man. They painted over the 14th century on up, man. Even to this very day. Whenever they show you a picture of the Lord, he always looks like this. He always looks Romanized or Edomite. Look like an Edomite. Long hair, blue eyes, pale skin, speaks with a soft, feminine voice, loves everybody. Forgive everybody for their sins. But when you read the scriptures, the Lord is a so-called black man with white woolly hair, skin of bronze, eyes red as fire. And he don't forgive everybody for their sins, man. He didn't die on the cross and was risen for all people of the earth, man. He died on the cross and was risen for the elect of Israel, ultimately all of Israel, man. Okay? He had a fro. He had a big beard that was white at 33 years old. Why is that? Because he was full of wisdom. Okay, acquainted with grief. That's why his eyes are red, because he's great. But this guy, they never show you this guy is great. They never show you this guy of getting angry. They never show you this guy of separating himself from you people. Okay? But see, these are two different Christ, man. Okay? Real quick. Corinthians 11 and 4. For if he that cometh preach of another, Yahawashah, whom we have not preached, or if ye receive another spirit, which ye have not received, or another gospel, which ye have not accepted, ye might also bear with them. That's right. Because this God, this God, everybody sins. Everybody can receive repentance according to this Jesus. But according to this Yahawashah, okay, Salvation is for the Israel. Repentance of sins is for Israel, man. He was sent on this earth to be an adoption for Israel, not the rest of the world. So if you receive this Jesus, man, you better bear with them, man. You gotta fight. Why? Because this isn't the gospel. This Jesus teaches a different gospel. That the kingdom of heaven is gonna be for all people, and that everybody can be saved, and we're all gonna float on clouds together. That's false, man. That's a false Yahweh shot. That's a false Christ, because this one, he teaches you who the kingdom is for, Israel. He teaches you who salvation is for, Israel. Okay? So again, we out here breaking down the covenant cast that was put on over all people, man. Because that's what that vibration got a lot of people caught up, man. But really, it's the Heavenly Father that put you in his hands. He says what? He said that both the seed and the deceiver are his, man. Okay? Father shall send them strong delusions that they should believe a lie. So here it is, with the truth that you might be saved. We're telling our people the truth, that you're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. We're telling you the Heavenly Father's name. We're telling you that salvation is going to come in your lifetime, but they don't want to receive it. Instead, we're telling you that the Lord, who the one the world he calls Christ, is a so-called black man, and he's coming back to his people. okay, for Israelites. Okay, for the people of color. Starting off with so-called Negro, all the way down to so-called Mexican. We're telling you the truth, but you don't want to receive it. You rather receive a lie that Christ died for everybody, that he loves everybody, that he's a white man. Hey, and you growing up, you believe in the Bible? Okay, of course you don't. So, but you're from the world. Well, this is deceivable, this man. Because according to the scriptures, the Heavenly Father is a so-called friend. But this lie that people would rather receive. They go to church, they tell people that God loves everybody, that everybody can be saved, right? They say that in church, right? Well, according to the scriptures, that's not true. According to the scriptures, when you read in the book of Romans, it tells you that the Lord sent the one you call Jesus, which is a black man, but the Israelites. It tells you in the book of Acts, chapter 5, verse 29. The book of Acts 5 and 29, right here, real quick. Acts 5 and 29, it says this. Then Peter and the rest of the apostles and the other apostles began to say, "Us unto God rather than men. God of our fathers raised up the homicide with his own Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. Him as God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sin." Now, the question is Israel the whole world? No, they're not. Israel is a nation. It's the Lord's people, okay? Israel is a separate nation between itself. And then you got all these Western nations underneath them. So the Lord says, when you call Jesus, you feel what? Savior and a prince to give repentance and to give repentance to Israel, not the whole world. Okay, so they're telling this. A lot of people believe is that God loves everybody. They say God don't hate, right? They say God is love. He doesn't hate. But when you read Romans 9 and 13, it says, Jacob have I love, but Esau have I hate. I didn't say that. The Lord said that. So the Lord does hate. Because it's written in the book. This is the book of the Lord. Hey, men that will move by the Spirit of the Heavenly Father.
Have you met those guys that wrote the books you learned in college?
You didn't go to college, you go to high school?
Yeah.
Okay, and so those textbooks that you read, did you meet any of those authors that they information in there?
But do I believe in it?
Okay.
That's the question. No, I don't.
Yeah, but the Romans 3:3 says, so what? What if some did not believe?
So what?
The scripture says that. I didn't say that. I don't know what the scripture says.
Yeah, but it's says, up to you to believe it or not.
But that's what I'm telling you. I believe it. So Romans 3:3 says, for what if some not believe? Shall that make the unbeliever? For what if some did not believe? Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect? God forbid. But let the heavenly Father be true, and every man alike. And as it is written, that thou mayest be justified in thy sayings, and mayest overcome when thou art judged. So everything I'm saying, right? I'm reading out of scripture, I believe it, right? So if it all comes to pass, then guess what? It's gonna make you a liar. Because you said you don't believe. Which is not given to you to believe anyway, it's given to the elect, it's given to the Israelites. Because you're not an Israelite. We know this. What's your nationality?
I'm American.
What's your nationality? What's your father? Japanese?
Right.
Yeah.
So
is your father Japanese?
Yeah.
Okay, that would make you an Ammonite, man. You come from the nation of Ammon. That means that you're not an Israelite. And that it wasn't given for you to believe because it was only given to the Israelites. The saints of the Heavenly Father. And you are Ammonite. If you go back to your forefathers, the Ammonite, a so-called Japanese man, then you.
What, we're going to hell?
No.
Where are we going?
You're going into slavery underneath us. Underneath the children of Israel. You're laughing, but it's the truth. All the nations that devoured us are going to be devoured. Because the nation of Ammon in the ancient world, y'all had us in slavery. Y'all had us in subjection. Y'all weren't calling yourself Japanese then. Y'all were calling yourself Ammonites.
Okay, who's we?
Me? The Ammonites. You. If he a Japanese, are you Japanese?
Yeah. The same thing as it.
Okay, yeah, so you're an Ammonite.
Okay.
You're an Ammonite.
Jesus.
Your forefathers did though.
I have no relationship
with
them.
Yeah, you do. According to the scriptures, you do.
I don't give a fuck about the shit.
Of course you don't, because you're an Ammonite.
Because I didn't live in those times.
You don't. You did though.
What
everything,
did I
everything that is new under the sun. The scripture says there's nothing new under the sun. Everything that is has always been.
We had iPhones?
Hey, oh, it's called. The iPhone is not with the U and the throne.
What's the internet?
And I'm telling you what the internet is. So yes, all of these things existed. you know it, but they all existed.
I'm just curious, though, what is your point?